Hey, what is Signal in Angular and why it's more important to learn it right now? We'll see in this video. Hi everyone, this is Subrat and you are watching Fun of Heuristics. So on this channel, we'll make video like this, which is related to programming and web development. So please consider subscribing if you haven't yet. And I know you already at least heard about Angular Signal. It's quite a buzz everywhere. But in this video, we're going to see in depth. What is Signal? Why we should use it? Why it got introduced in Angular in the first place? And why it's the right time to learn it now so that you will be little ahead of others when Signals go full on. So we'll see the first one. What is Signals in Angular? So we can think of Signal as a system which notify Angular that I have some changes. So suppose you have used a signal in your component. Now your component can notify Angular that I have some state changes, so go ahead and re-render it. And that helps us in optimizing the rendering process of Angular. And how Signal works? In a short note, each signal emits its value to all its children, just like an observable. And it's little different than observable, not little, lot different than observable. And I will also explain where you should use Signal and where you should use observable. Now you'll ask me, Subrat, what's wrong with the current thing? What's wrong in the existing thing that Angular introduced a signal? And that comes to our next question, why Signal? So the signal is introduced by SolidJS. So the Angular team saw that it's a very good system which can be introduced to Angular and can optimize the chain detection, and it will change a lot of things how Angular works. What Angular team did was they worked closely with the creator of SolidJS and raised a pull request on February 15th, I guess. And after that, the world goes crazy. So what's the benefit here? And I will going to explain it details later in the video. So when our change detection runs, currently Angular doesn't have any mechanism to show that which component has change detection, until you have a chain detection strategy on push and you are triggering by yourself. So what Angular does is it rerun the rendering process throughout the application, and that's inefficient. If you think like you are changing a way down component below, but all of your component got re-render, and that's becoming a less optimized rendering process, and that Signal will going to solve. Now we'll go to our code base and see a very simple use of Signal. But this will be not the end. In the next video, we're going to make a whole application using Signal. So first of all, I would like to inform you that Angular Signal is right now is in developer preview, which is I'm using Angular 16. So when in the time of recording this video, it's on developer preview mode. If you're watching the video later, maybe Angular 17 is released, then you have Angular Signal edge production. But if you're using Angular 16, don't use the Signal in your production app, but have a hands-on on it so that you'll be ready when Angular 17 will come and you'll be ready to implement Signal in your production. And then later in the video today, I will show you why it's deadly important to learn Signal right now. So this is a sample component, which is a standalone component. And here, we have set the chain detection strategy to onPush just to show you that Signal notify a changes to Angular. We have set a signal name as a signal of one of heuristic, and this is a writable signal. And don't worry, I'll going to explain everything in the next video, like signal, compute, effects, and a lot more thing where we should use and why we should use that. Everything we're going to cover by implementing a to-do application. So stay tuned and subscribe to the channel so that you will be notified for that video, and it's coming very soon. So we have just a signal, and we are setting that value inside a timeout of 1 second just to so that we are getting some data. And if I'll go to the HTML here, we are calling the signal, and signal will be consumed like this by having a function call to the signal. And I know I should show all the things of what the methods are available in the signal in this video, but I want to explain you the theory behind it or the change detection strategy, how it will work. So I thought to divide this video in two parts so that it will not be a very long video. So I'll just start the server. And before starting the server, I will just comment this just to show you that after 1 second, we are changing the title to some new title, but it will not be rendered on our page because we have change detection strategy on push and we are not using change detection reference and detecting the changes to notify the Angular that we have some change in our component. And you just saw here we are getting fun of heuristic, which is our signal, and we are getting Angular signal standalone. But we have already changed this value inside our set timeout. What I will do now, I will just uncomment the signal set value so that now when the signal is set, it will notify all its consumer as well as Angular, because Angular is now the consumer of the signal. So now if I'll go and refresh the page again, just to show you guys that after 1 second, things change. So what happened here? Why without signal, we haven't got the changes after 1 second, but we got with signal. When we set a signal value, it will notify all its consumer. So here we have a consumer in our HTML. So whenever your HTML got notified that there is some change, your component will got flagged. Flagged means flagged to change detection. And then when the next change detection cycle will run, it will run the change detection and relay out your page so that you can see the changes here. But without this, even if we are changing, setting the signal here, we're not going to see the change. It will be remain same as the first title we have set. And you can relate this with our async pipe. So if you have an observable and pipe that with an async pipe, then if any change in the observable will be reflected here, even if you have onPush strategy. The same thing goes with signal. By introducing signal, now we can notify Angular that we have a change in this component, and just re-render that. And I will going to show you now with a chart how things will going to happen. Suppose this is our application where we have multiple component one, component two, component three, and so on. And if you don't have onPush strategy, so it's running on Jones.js. It's running on normal Jones.js without onPush strategy, without signal, anything. Suppose you have a change below here in your application. As Angular doesn't know to check where the change happens, so what Angular will do now, it will rerun the change detection everywhere in the application. Now all your component has been re-rendered again just due to you have a change detection here, which is unfair. So to solve that, Angular introduced change detection strategy. And if you know how it works and if you can use it wisely, then your application will be smoother. So now we'll see how it works with Jones.js and onPush strategy. Have a scenario that we have multiple components and some of the components are onPush. So you can, I just say OP as onPush, and I can say this as OP. So we have these two component, each strategy as onPush, and the rest others might be onPush or might not be. We are not caring about them. So in this scenario, what will happen now, when we have a change detection, so whenever we are setting a value in signal, or if you remember your change detection strategy, and if you're running change detector reference dot mark for change, then what will going to happen is, suppose I have a change here in this component 8, now my component 8 will be flagged and it will say that there is something changed in my component. And what it will do, your component will notify the parent that I have some change, and this parent will notify this. Now what will happen, Angular will run change detection to these three component. So your component one says that, okay, I have some changes for my component three. So just try to re-render that. And your component three say that in the re-render request from the component one, and it will say that I have some changes for component eight. So re-render that. And that's how your component eight will get re-rendered. That's how current signal will going to work with onPush strategy. But now you'll ask me, Subrat, that this is already going to work. We know that, okay, signal gives us some benefit, which is going to use it, but it doesn't give us benefit over onPush strategy. Here, we're going to see what will going to happen in the future. And in the future, Angular will going to get rid of the zone.js. So in future, we'll not have zone.js and we'll call that as zoneless Angular. The name might change, but we're going to remove the zone.js from the Angular itself. So now what we're going to change is instead of component, we're going to render in basis of view. And this is what are some discussion going on. It's not 100% sure that this is going to happen, but similar to this will going to happen. You have a separate component with different views in it. All the views will be created by your any structural directive. So if you have ngif, ngfor, so those things will be act what as a single view. So whenever you will have a signal and you say that I have some change notified by a signal from here, that means you have set some value, updated some value, run the computation and everything, then only this component will going to re-render, nothing else. So what is the benefit here? That previously, if you remember in this scenario, for the onPush strategy scenario, we are notifying our parent component and re-rendering the whole subtree of our DOM. But in this scenario, as you have views, we can re-render the views itself. And that will make our application so fast. And you can re-render the only those part which are got affected due to some state changes. And this is why learning signal is necessary, because when this change will going to happen, you have to use signal. And you can ask me, Subrat, why Angular haven't used observable to use as a signal? And you might have heard everywhere that behavior, subject and signal has similar value. So now I will show you what is the basic difference of signal and an observable. And I have seen it from the creator of signal, so I'll just try to explain you as I can. So you can think the signal as you have a bucket with a value in it. So whenever you access the value, you get the value. But whenever you are adding something to it and replacing this value, means adding this and moving this out, now a signal will send a notification to all its consumers, similar to observable. And in case of observable, what's the difference is, you can think observable like a continuous flow of data. So whenever there is a data input, it will just go ahead and go out. This is a normal observable. So if we have multiple subscriber here, they all will be notified whenever there will be a new addition of data to it. But in the case of behavior subject, what we do the same flow as well as we have a record of previous emitted value. Where you should use observable and where you should use signal. So wherever you have some normal values, like calculating something, changing the text on the screen, changing the image, changing the values which will going to be rendered on the screen, those all can be used by a signal with all its benefit to notify to change detection and all. And where we should use observable, subject, behavior, subject and all, where we have an async operation, like we are calling to a server, getting the data, and then with the data, we'll do something else. In those scenario, observable is relevant. We have a huge benefit in signal which you don't have in observable. If you remember, if you are using observable a lot, you know that if you are subscribing to observable, then you have to unsubscribe them as well. Else, there will be a lot of memory leak, side effect in your application. And if you don't know how to use it quite efficiently, you will going to create a mess. But that will not going to happen in the case of signal, because the life of signal is bound to the life of your component. Your component destroyed, it will also going to erase out the memory for the signal. And that will be a biggest benefit for Angular ecosystem. at Angular is now going through a lot of changes, like introducing control flow. Now we are seeing a lot of RFCs. So this is what Signal is and why it's more important to learn it now. And in the next video, we're going to create a to-do application with Angular, Signal, and standalone component. So please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you will not miss the notification for that video. And if you are watching till now and you like the video, please give a thumbs up so that it will motivate me to make videos like this. So we're going to meet in the next video. Till that, stay happy. Bye-bye.